What's up, you guys? Just got home from running to Best Buy and grabbing a keyboard. I thought the one that came with that computer was gonna be decent. I mean, it had decent reviews, but it's really crappy. It's like a cheap generic keyboard that's got, a couple different color keys, for gaming stuff. Like, other than that, it's garbage. So I went out, splurged a little bit, got a SteelSeries Apex 5. A lot of cool features on this one. I really liked it. It was harder picking out a keyboard than the damn monitor. I was like, come on, man. But I knew my monitor was going to be here today. UPS, the app, said delivery was going to be between 12:45 and 4 o'clock or something like that, or 4:45. So I placed the order online, then I was kind of just waiting. I'm like, all right, he's in that next neighborhood over, the one that's like two streets with like, like two cross streets or whatever. And I mean, I'm talking the streets are, there's probably 50 houses in that whole neighborhood. So I'm like, all right, cool. He'll be here soon. So I get ready, I was like, all right, as soon as he gets here, I'm just gonna put it inside the door, then I'm gonna take off because it's gonna be cutting it close. It's gonna be right about 2 o'clock. So I refresh it, I go get dressed, use the bathroom, get a drink real quick. I refresh it again. He's still in that neighborhood. I'm like, oh my God, man, come on. So a few minutes later goes by and he's in my neighborhood. I'm like, all right, sweet. So there's a couple entrances to mine, and then there's like long crossroads before like the roads that go like this. Like there's ones that go like this first. He goes into my entrance and then goes down that crossroad and goes all the way to the other side and then starts going up. I'm like, oh my God, this really? So I was kind of salty. I'm like, you know what? I'm just gonna fly to Best Buy real quick, pick that up. And then, I mean, if he's anything like the other neighborhood, the huge one, which is kind of like how mine is, it's not quite as big, but I was like, he was in that neighborhood for like 2 hours. I'm like, so I got plenty of time, I think I got plenty of time. I'm gonna fly to Best Buy, pick up the keyboard, because you don't even gotta get out of the car. They just literally, put it in your trunk for you or whatever. So I fly out the door, I'm going down the highway. Like 5 minutes after I leave my house, I get another email like, your package is almost there or something like that. And I click on the map again. He's like one street over. I'm like, oh my God. So like, I think five people in my neighborhood had, packages to deliver, but the other neighborhood had 500. So of course, he drops it off and I'm not home, but it's no big deal. We get that Ring doorbell camera, so I can literally just stare at it if I want to, but it pops up too, like when a person, it'll say there's motion if there's a car, and then it'll actually say like there's a person. So yeah, anyways though, so I get back home, everything's there. My other package came too from Amazon, which wasn't supposed to be here till tomorrow, which is my mouse pad. Of course it's RGB, come on now. Well, it's rain, mind you, like it's a blizzard outside. It's, but with that being said, it's also like 35 degrees, so it's snowing, yet it's instantly melting, and then half of it's rain. So I don't know if you want to call that like sleet, but it looks like snow. So look at the way he leaves the package. They've got like bags where they can like put it over it when it's raining. Smart, right? This, I mean, obviously it's inside, but this is seriously how it was sitting outside. Like, you put a bag on the bottom. All that's gonna do is catch water and hold it. Why didn't you put one over the top? Dude, I could rant to you guys about UPS and FedEx and the post office for hours. Like, this is whatever, you know what I mean? Like, obviously you guys see it's mostly dry. There's a little bit of moisture on top, but the other stuff that they've done is just absurd. But I mean, this, look at this box though. This, what was the point of this? Like, the top is like smashed down. The sides aren't even taped. Like, I mean, what? And I think the box inside of here is only this big. Like, what the hell? Let's open this up on camera and make sure it's all right. Oh, nice. Yeah, the bottom's all wet. Imagine that. The bottom's all wet, even though there was a bag on it. Oh, because the bag was holding all the water that it was catching from the top. Well, I mean, so far the monitor looks all right, so that's good. This thing is heavy. But all right, guys, so I'm gonna go ahead and get this installed and I'll be back. If you want to see unboxings, all that is gonna be on my other channel, Brian's Garage, which I'll link right here. So here we are in the middle of April and everything's covered in snow. I'm going to get Buffalo Wild Wings for dinner. We've been craving it so bad. I love their wings. Well, boneless wings, let me rephrase that. I love like traditional wings, but I don't like Buffalo Wild Wings traditional wings. I love their boneless though. So I usually get those or like a burger there. They got really, for like the first time ever, like all, I don't know how you guys are, but me and Shelby are the type, like, when it comes to a food we like, we never try, like, well, I don't want to say we never try anything new, but, like, we're very, very, like, we all, I don't know the term, there's a term for it, I can't remember it, but we always order the same thing. Like, once we find something we really like, that's what we order. Like, it's, you know, like, I get the, you know, from Subway, I get the same thing every time. You know, from McDonald's, I get the same thing every time. You know, the Buffalo Wild Wings, there's, like, two different things I get, but I usually get the boneless wings with Parmesan garlic or like a mild is usually pretty good. I love spicy foods, but like I prefer flavor over the spiciness, like, you know, the Blaze and stuff. That's just stupid. Like my mom likes that crap. You know, cry as you eat it type foods. I'm like, that's just nasty. Like last time I went out to eat with her at Buffalo Wild Wings, she gets like the traditional wings with I think it's Blazin', their hottest one, whatever it is, that's what she gets. And she's eating them, she's like, you want one, they're so good. And she's got like tears rolling down her face, her skin is flushed, you know, like her nose is running, she's got to keep, you know, like wiping her nose off. I'm like, what flavor is that? There's like, that's just burning your taste buds off. I usually go with like a mild. Buffalo is like my favorite flavor. Like it's spicy, you know, it's got some heat, but it's, you know, it's not like, you know, burn your mouth hot. We are here at Buffalo Wild Wings now. Well, I am here. I'll be back. All right, so picked up our food. Man, was that a madhouse. Holy crap. So obviously the restaurants are closed, so you can just go in and, you know, get takeout or whatever, like pick it up. So I go in there and pick it up, and they got like a sign on the door, only 5 people at a time. You know, if there's 5 in there, please wait outside. But their windows are like tinted, so you can't really see. So, I mean, that's kind of like, I don't know. I mean, it is what it is, whatever. So I walk in, I'm the 5th person, and there's 4 of us in line. And then there's one guy like off to the side waiting, like, you know, he placed an order and it wasn't ready yet or something. So the person that was at the window, finally, you know, they get their stuff, they leave. So the person, the older lady that was behind them, which is not the person in front of me, but the person in front of the person in front of me, she goes up to the window and she says a name or whatever for like the order. And the lady's like, I'm sorry, we don't have anything for that name. Would it be under a different name? And she says, I couldn't really hear much of what she was saying, but she says another name, and she's like, I'm sorry, man, there's nothing for that either. And she's like, do you have the email, like, she's like, we ordered it online. She's like, do you have, like, the email confirmation on your phone or anything? She's like, no, I don't have that. And she's like, well, what was in the order? I don't know. Like, come on, you know, like, she didn't know anything that was in the order. She apparently didn't have the right name for it. Didn't have any kind of email confirmation. And she's up there, then she's like, well, hold on. And then she gets on the phone, and I'm just like, you know, lady, you could move to the side and let, you know, there was like, I mean, I'm no lie, probably 15 cars in the parking lot with people waiting. Like, you could let somebody else, you know, grab their food and take off while you're trying to figure out whatever the hell you did. So she continues to stand there, continues talking to this poor girl, and I felt so bad for the lady taking orders. Like, she just looks so stressed out and just, you know, like, almost like you can tell when somebody wants to say something that they know they can't, you know, and it's just like, I'm sure these fast food and retail and stuff workers, like, they probably just want to cuss half these people out, understandably, because, like,
even though, like, I'll sit here and bitch, like, yeah, we go to McDonald's and they mess our food up all the time. It's frustrating. Like, I'm not, when I say that, you know, I'm not saying, like, oh, your job is easy. You know, there's nothing stressful about it or anything like that. Like, I understand that job. You know, Shelby worked in fast food. You know, I know without, I haven't worked in it, but, you know, I've heard playing. You know, she did it for years. So I know, you know, how it is behind the counter and stuff, you know. So I never, like, judge, per se, but, you know, I do want the correct food. You know, I paid for this. I want this. You know, that's not asking too much. But, like, when I've been out in public during this stuff going on, I've just noticed that, like, there's a lot of asshole customers and rude people every day of the year. But with this stuff going on right now, I've just noticed it, like, it blew up how many just rude asshole people there are. And it blows my mind. Like, these people don't want to be out working in this shit. You know, they're out here working against their... Most of them would choose to sit at home and get unemployment if it was, you know, anything close to what they were making. And, you know, most of them did not get that option. You know, or... I know, like, a few of my buddies, like, their friends or family got, you know, like... Yeah, you don't have to come to work anymore, you know, until this stuff passes. But you're not getting unemployment. You got to use your own vacation time. And if you don't have any, you know, then you're not getting paid, you know. So it's like a lot of these people, like, they say, you know, these people are heroes. You know, they're keeping the world going around. Like, yeah, but, like, it's against their will, though. You know what I'm saying? Like, absolutely, they are doing great things for society. You know, even a fast food worker, you know, you're providing food, you know, when a lot of people can't make it through these lines in the stores and stuff like that. But are you waking up every day? Like, my argument to that is, like, these people, most of these people, they're not waking up every day like, yeah, you know, I can't wait to go put on my apron and, you know, fry some fries and flip some burgers and deal with asshole people all day every day when there's a pandemic going around and this nasty virus. They don't have a choice, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, I don't know, I've seen, like, on Facebook, it's just constant arguments and, you know, about all this stuff. But there's my buddy Frank. You know, so just be, my whole point of that rant, just be kind to these people. Like, even, trust me, like, I'm fat. I love fast food. When my order's messed up, I get pissed. But I'm still not pissed off at the person handing me the food or the person, you know, at the counter or whatever. Like, you know, mistakes happen. Like, just say, hey, you know, you guys messed up. And I get it too. Like, a lot of times you don't realize it until you get home and stuff like that. That fucking sucks. But just do what I do. Just be that fat person that sits there and checks your order before you leave now.
So guys, here it is. I kept it in that same spot that you saw. Actually, I don't know if I showed it, but I put it over here by the fireplace. I remember it used to be over here. I'm still not done cleaning the table, actually. I've got a lot of junk on there to go through. But everything else is pretty much good. But, yeah, let me show you my new setup now. So now I got my monitor today. I got my keyboard and my keyboard and mouse pad. Finally got everything set up. I just did some cable management, so everything's nice and tidy. You don't see any wires dangling down. And I wanted to show it at night so you can get the full effect of all the RGB. So let's start with the tower. So as you can see, there's two fans. There's two here, and then there's two more over here. There's a push-pull setup going on. There's a radiator for the water cooling for the CPU. All of them are color matching. The CPU cooler is too. The graphics card is not, but it still looks good. And then there's a bottom strip to match. And I've got a button on top where I can change it. This is probably my second favorite one. Just, you get like the color flow, but, you know, it's a little bit different. I'm gonna press it again. Another option. Sorry if you hear the dogs snoring. They snore like humans. And then this is like the breathing function or whatever, where it kind of like fades in and out to each color. And then another, like a halo glowing whatever. Hit it again. And you got solid colors, just red, green, blue, white, yellow, kind of like an aqua. magenta or pink, and then just straight rainbow, like solid, and then back to color flow. And of course I can hold the button, turn them off, and turn it back on. It stays where it was. This thing has an SSD and a hard drive. I've got 32 gigs of RAM in it. The graphics card is a GeForce RTX 2070 Super. It's the dual fan one. This thing is running on balls to the wall, having every setting on high. So smooth. And now I've got my Dell monitor in, which is a, I'll put the model number right here, I forget. But it's got a 1 millisecond response time, 165 hertz refresh rate. It's 2K. The picture is out of this world. And then down to the keyboard and the mouse pad. It is a SteelSeries Apex 5 keyboard. Just the regular mouse that came with it, but it is a gaming mouse. It does have buttons on the side. You can adjust the sensitivity. So it's a good mouse, a good starter mouse. I'm definitely gonna upgrade soon, but it does the job for now. And this keyboard is super cool. So it's got a little display down here. Let me start over here. So it's got a wheel that you roll up and down. That's like volume and stuff. You can tap it for mute, hit this button, that's your media, like play, pause, skip, or rewind. Each key has a light behind it, so it's, you can program every key to do whatever you want. So I have it to where like numb lock and caps lock and stuff, there's no light for it, so I just have the light on the key change color. You see I wrote my name on there. You gotta write it on the screen, that's why it looks kinda crappy. Couldn't think of what else to put for now, but when you tap a key, it turns red and it fades out. So like, see, then it just fades back to its normal color. So you can see numb lock is off because it's regular flowing with the colors on the keyboard. Hit it and it's green. Scroll lock, same thing. Caps lock. So just some cool little features. So this screen, I can actually basically change to put whatever I want. Like, we use Discord to chat when we're playing the game, and I put on the screen to have, like, if you've ever used Discord, you know, up here when you're playing a game, it shows everybody's name in the party. And to me, that's annoying. That takes up valuable screen space. So now my keyboard actually shows me who's talking. It'll show their name and a little, like, microphone kind of talking. I can make it to where, like, any button lights up for, like, you know, my buddy Tyler, if I want him to be number two, it'll light up the number two key when he's talking. Our buddy Dan or Jake, you know what I'm saying? So each person can have, like, be programmed to light up a certain key or something. These ones up here, when I talk, they turn blue. And then when I'm not talking, they're just regular color. So I know, like, my mic's active. They change color when it's muted, for instance. Keyboard is crazy. I love it. I can't figure out half the settings, but it is super cool. Of course we got the monster editing machine here, the Mac, as I bump my head on the chandelier back here. Still got my controller charger over there. I haven't really thought of a better option for it yet, but let me go ahead and get some lights on. As you can see, I'm much better than my setup that was over here. That's where that little air conditioner thing is. I actually just had this random piece of like ABS plastic that I threw up. It's got kind of a texture. And I just literally set it there with some double-sided tape. It looks way better than having that ugly giant air conditioner showing. Got my free speakers over here and over here. I love this monitor so much. I want to order a second one, move it over slightly, and then have another one right there. That's if I don't get the room done first, but yeah. So I absolutely love this setup, you guys. I'm like glued to my computer now. It's just so fun to be here. The games on this thing are awesome. Show the keyboard and actually I can change some of the settings. So let me turn the light back off. God, these dogs snore like humans. Orange is kind of cool. It's all like warm colors. I'm not really into the warm colors though, so. But it does look cool. Head back, go to custom. I can do. You can do lights off, you know, where. And you can make it where it like fades as you hit a button, which is really cool. That would be trippy. Breathe multi. You got phase where like part of it's off, which is kind of cool, but I like it all being lit up. The prism. That's where it's at. But you can go back. You got just different settings for everything. Of course, you can turn the brightness down. Yeah, I'm super, super, super happy with the setup. Very few things I would tweak. Obviously, my desk space is very limited because of the location. My ideal desk would go from at least there to like the end of this window on both sides, actually. So. It wasn't, so it's definitely not cluttered by any means, but I would like to be able to have more open desk space, essentially, you know, for like something like that, you know, a headset holder. But obviously I wanted something small and cheap that's temporary for now. When I do put it up in my bedroom, I wanted something cheap and I don't want to say simple, you know, because obviously it was kind of a hassle getting all this stuff together, but something cheap and, you know, that's not going to break the bank for now. Because, I mean, with the way this stuff's going with this Corona stuff, who knows when I'm going to be able to rent that machine. So, that machine, by the way, to blow the insulation in the walls. That's basically what I'm waiting for in the room. I believe I mentioned that in the other video. My next purchase is going to be a nice microphone. My phone microphone is really good. Aside from when I'm outside and it's windy, obviously. I like it. I think the quality is pretty good. You know, there's minor tweaks I would make if I could, but you know, I'm satisfied with it. As of computer wise, like I do like to, I'm obviously at the computer a lot. So sometimes I dub over the video, like I talk over it, you know, if I wanted to mention something or change something. And the audio on this, it does the job again, you know, it's a built-in microphone. It's not great. Here's a quick demo of the, iMac microphone with no editing. Here's with just a little bit of tweaks through iMovie, nothing fancy. So I would love to have like a universal desk microphone, but like a good quality one, you know, for like streamers and stuff like that. I hate wearing a headset. So I've got this headset, you know, I've got a big head, so. And then the mic's right there. I feel like this mic isn't great. And I feel like it picks up way more than I want it to, you know, like obviously being down in my living room, you know, Shelby would be right over here 5 feet away, you know, watching TV or watching YouTube on her phone. And, you know, I would never ask her to like turn it down or something like that for my game. You know, that's irrelevant. I want a microphone set up that won't pick up so much background noise. You know what I'm saying? So I think they're called like a cardioid microphone or something. Maybe, I don't remember, but it's like a microphone. Then it's got like the circle kind of filter in front of it that, you know, makes it not pop and stuff like that. Something like that here would be nice. But aside from that, I think this is pretty much it until the room's done up there. You know, I might, of course, get like I'd love a headset holder right here because headset take up so much room. And I'm not gonna lie, I suck on the keyboard. I am horrible. I play with my Xbox controllers a lot still. So there's this little thing. It's a Xbox wireless adapter. And this, like my headset, is Xbox only. There's no, you know, you can't connect it to a Windows computer. There's no Bluetooth, stuff like that. So you buy one of these, they're about 20 bucks on Amazon, plugs into your USB port. And then what it does is it allows you to connect all your wireless Xbox stuff to your PC. So when I turn my headset on, it connects, all the audio comes through here. You know, the microphone works for party chat and all that. And I can connect my controllers, so, which is really cool to be able to play. But yeah, so having my headset on there, you can see how much room that stupid thing takes up. So I'd love, you know, back there by that speaker, just a little stand to kind of drop it on. And I could do something cheap right there with a hook, you know, on our fireplace mantle. But, you know, I want something nicer looking because obviously when I move the desk, the fireplace won't be there. Yeah, if you guys checked out my review of this speaker, thank you very much. A company sent this to me to, you know, unbox it and review it. And just want to show them that they chose a good person. So if you guys check it out, be sure to leave a thumbs up. And if you're interested in it or you have any questions or whatever, just shoot me a comment. I think it would be kind of cool, you know, one day when I get like to a certain point, maybe do like a giveaway. I don't know of what, you know, maybe other companies that, you know, if other companies were to contact me and, you know, send me something and, you know, I don't know, do like an unboxing and then give that away. That would be kind of cool. But yeah, I guess we'll go down that road when we get that far. So Chubby's already in bed because she's got to open tomorrow. So she's got to be to work at like 6 a.m. Speaking of work, they sent out a text today. My line is not going back until May 18th. So my birthday is May 10th, which is Mother's Day this year. I was born on Mother's Day in 1992. And this year it falls on Mother's Day again. Kind of sucks. It's supposed to be my day. But my birthday is May 10th. I'm now off still on my birthday, which is sweet. My job, you have the option. You can work on your birthday and get double time, or you can take it off and get 8 hours of pay. So obviously I worked one time, regretted it instantly because I was just trying to grind and make as much money as I could. It ruined the day. I was like, you know, it'll be fine. When I get off work, you know, we'll go out to eat, you know, go hang out, do like our normal birthday stuff, you know, like our routine or tradition, and it'll be sweet. No, it literally ruined the day for me. Like I got home, I was so tired, I was worn out. Like I just didn't want to do anything. It sucked, you know, because Shelby was home all day. She took my birthday off. To this day, like, I regret that. It sucked. You know, that check, obviously, it was a little bit better than normal, but it wasn't worth it. You know, like, that's my birthday. It comes around once a year, and I worked, and it sucked. So if you got to work on your birthdays, I apologize. That's terrible. So as of my last update, we were supposed to go back May 4th, and at first, I was like, oh, they're definitely going to extend it again. Oh, for sure. And then, like, the more the stuff goes on, it seems like people are kind of, people as in, like, governors and presidents are kind of trying to, like, rush things back to being normal, which it's going to make this stuff spike again. Like, I don't know. What do you guys think about that, too? Like, I saw a thing on one of the Ohio Toledo news pages I follow, that their governor's thinking about trying to slowly open things back up starting May 1st. And, you know, what's your thoughts? And I'm like, I want to see everything open. Don't get me wrong. You know, I don't want to be sheltered. You know, nobody wants that. But at the same time, though, like, if this virus has the tendencies that they say it has, which, you know, who knows? There are people lying out there about this stuff. Then I personally believe that if you start opening stuff in the beginning of May, that you're gonna, even if, you know, at first we were going like this and then it started skyrocketing and, you know, now it's only slightly going up, like, I believe that trend will quickly go up again. Like, you're gonna see it go like this and then back right back up, because you're gonna have so many people going out. Like, people now are just gonna be leaving their houses just to leave, you know what I'm saying? They're not just going to be going out like, oh, finally I can go to, you know, Walmart and shop normally. Like, no, everybody is going to be leaving their houses just to go walk around stores, just to go walk around the mall. You know, like, there's going to be so many people out in public that this stuff is just going to spread like wildfire again. So I don't think it's a good idea personally, but what do I know? I'm just a guy who browses Facebook and Google. What do you guys think about it? I think New York was saying that too. I'm like, New York was like the worst state, if I'm not mistaken, like by far. And they're not even that big of a state, which is crazy. I feel like no matter what happens, we will bounce back. It might not be, you know, next month. It might not be this summer. You know, it might not be till winter. It might be a year from now, but I think everything will be just perfectly okay.
it's just unfortunate for the people who are getting screwed over by their jobs or unemployment. Like, some unemployments are an absolute joke. Like, even Michigan, when I was like, that's the most you can make? Like, how the hell could you pay anything on that? And then there's other states that make Michigan look like they're getting a lot. You know, like when I was in, I collect in Ohio because I work in Ohio. And at first I was like, oh, that's it? You know, like the first time I had to do it when we got laid off, you know, for our retooling and stuff and like a summer shutdown, I was like, oh my God, that's like a third of what I make a week. That kind of sucks. But, you know, I was like, I'll be able to get by. I'll be able to pay bills. I just won't have any extra money. And now I'm like, extremely thankful for the amount it is, because I see some of these other states, I'm like, how can you pay two of your utility bills, let alone all of your bills, and put food on the table and stuff like that? Like, yeah, I just hope everybody's doing good. I know a lot of you guys aren't, and I hope things get better very quick. You know, I hope you guys make it through. Just keep your heads up, stay strong. Stay busy if you can. That always helps me, you know, if I'm ever, you know, in a bad space in my head, you know, just try to stay busy, or, you know, watch movies, clean your house, clean your car, stuff like that. And just know, like, it always gets better. You survive this long, so it's a little bump in the road, I guess. But, yeah, anyways, out of all these dark speeches, time to play some games. We got our Buffalo Wild Wings. I recorded that. It wasn't that good. It's like, it wasn't bad, but like the wings had like a burnt kind of charred taste to them. Both of our fries were like ice cold when we got home, and not even a 10-minute drive, and I had the heat on. No memory strikes again. For some reason, instead of letting me know that it stopped recording, it just stopped recording, and I didn't realize it. So, unfortunately, the last couple minutes of this clip are gone, but that was pretty much it. You didn't really miss anything. I was just talking about our Buffalo Wild Wings, but that's going to wrap up this vlog. Hope you guys enjoyed it, and see you guys next time.